All right, here we are in the finals, and we won the die roll. We will be going first, though not with this particular hand. That's a pretty easy mulligan. This one, yeah, this one's probably a keep. This is one of those mediocre hands that's not really great, but probably better than a random five. We've got a Sidisi's Faithful to either keep the beats at bay or bounce some biggish threat early, and then we've got a dragon we can play on turn three. And you know, with any planes, we've got a Student of Ojutai, which goes a long way towards stabilizing the board. So, yeah, this is the type of hand that I could see going either way, but I'm not going to go to five with. All right, well, doing it. Still just going to keep this faithful. Don't see a big reason to run it out there right away. Yeah, file Dragonfire could be good. I think I still just want to play this dragon face down, though. We can actually get two life out of that vial of Dragonfire if we play it after the student, and especially since our opponent hasn't done anything yet. It looks like we're going to get twin bolted here, and we do. Fair enough. Like I said, our student should do a pretty good job of getting in the way of whatever our opponent plays on the second or third turn. Yeah, like Hardened Berserker. Obviously pretty nice against, a student's pretty nice against that. Oh, wow. It's a good draw. Still think we do block here, though. Could see the argument for not. And see what our opponent does. Decent amount of combat tricks that get Hardened Berserker right through our student. All right. Not going to have to make that decision. I like that. Will of the Naga. All right, well, let's get this Vial of Dragonfire down. Like I said, we get to gain a couple of life. And I think I'm just going to leave it up here. Leaving up the vial means that our opponent just really can't attack with either of these two creatures. Of course, they can chip in there with the spirit, but you know, we just have blocks and then can threaten using the vial. And it just means that even if they've got a combat trick, they really just can't attack us. Yeah, well, it looks like we found a target. Yeah, well, I'm gonna use it here. Sabretooth Outrider, is that what you're called? Yeah, Outrider attacks nicely through. That's 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. So easily into the formidable range. It would have first strike, and that's a card that just has to die. Oh, hello. If it isn't our friend, the Youthful Scholar, here to wreak some havoc. Do I attack here? Yeah, I'm going to attack. I'll trade this off for a Hardened Berserker here and leave my opponent with not a whole lot going on. This is a trade I'm not excited but willing to make. I should have obviously attacked before combat, but I'll be honest, didn't think it through. Yeah, this works. And now I like this board state. This sets us up really well. Can Sidisi's Faithful away the Scholar in a pinch, but I'd rather just have a Scale Guard going. Because I think we're actually going to be the beat down here pretty shortly. All right, I'm in. This doesn't set up the play as well with Elite Scale Guard if we were to draw a land, but as you can see, sometimes you don't draw a land, so it's better. Another Outrider? All right. It's pretty good. So, I think we want to go Deceiver plus Reduce in Stature on this guy. Just sort of develop our mana out the best we can. Or our board out, I mean. eventually setting up for the scale guard, which unfortunately, unless we draw another creature, it looks like the scale guard is going to pick up the counters itself, which is, it's a fine thing. I mean, it's a 4/5 that taps down one of their blockers, but the thing that's less good about it is that if they do have an answer for it, then you're kind of on eggs basket one. 5/3 with trample. Yeah, okay. So let's see what our draw step brings us. An island. Okay, well, we're going to play the scale guard. Get the counters going on that. I'm trying to decide if I want to play Sidisi's Faithful. I'm not really seeing it as doing a whole lot here. I can basically trade it for the spirit token. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Actually, you know what? That is worth it. It gets the spirit token off the battlefield, and it also means that that whatever that thing's called is actually only 4 power. So that I can block it with scale guard. So I think that is worth it. And also it just takes that annoying token away, and which is going to be chipping away at our life total pretty consistently there. So I think I can live with that. Mm-hmm. Oh, wow. Profaner. Profaner, Sacking Deceiver bounces the whole team. Gets rid of 2 goblin tokens and the morph, but unfortunately puts the Outrider back in our opponent's hand, which isn't really where we want it. So you know what I'm going to do here? I'm going to attack. And tap down a goblin. And see if he wants to chump block with the Outrider. He might just feel like, you know, I got to get some value out of the Outrider here. Doesn't fall for it. Okay. Oh, he wants to keep it up so that he has an extra creature for that dash thing. All right, that makes sense. In that case, I'm just going to go for Will of the Naga here. He'll probably dash in that guy. And he wants it to be extra big, and then I'll tap it down, and I'll tap down the morph as well. He's not going to do that, okay? Maybe just play it. Kind of want that to happen, actually, because then my Profaner gets even better. Just annoyed about the Sabretooth Outrider going back to hand, but I might just have to accept that that's going to happen here. Opponent has 4 cards in hand, though, so we are definitely up against something. Sandstorm Charger. We drew Great Teacher's Decree, though. That's interesting. So this thing has 4 toughness. So I have an attack here. That part's pretty straightforward. So let's do that, actually. I don't think I want a Great Teacher's Decree just yet. I think I want to do it next turn. Tap down the big guy. And then I think we'll see a block here soon. All right. We got there. Now I can do the profaner and get rid of the morph and the two goblins. It won't get rid of the charger, but the single creature is fine. And we're going to sacrifice the deceiver here. So get rid of those. And then what we're basically just trying to do is set up for a Great Teacher's Decree and a double swing here for the win. A lot can go wrong. Yeah, I'm going to attack anyway because probably won't have any good blocks. Though that is interesting. It means our opponent probably doesn't have anything huge. Just the morph. No, you got something else. The Forerunners. Okay. So how much damage does this do? 3, 6, 7, 8. That could be lethal-ish depending on what this morph is. We've clearly got nice attacks, but I think maybe we just want to run the Sandstorm Charger out there as a blocker. We can hit for 7. That brings him down to 10, and then we can set up the win the next turn with Great Teacher's Decree if my opponent goes all in. Yeah, I think that's a risk we're going to have to take here. We can win next turn. And we'll have a blocker, a 3-4 blocker back to get in the way of the Kolaghan Forerunners or the Morph. And if they have a way to get through all of that, then handshake. But we don't have enough to force a block with Great Teacher's Decree this turn. So my opponent could be like, sure, we play Decree. They take 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11. They go to 6, but then we're taking 3, 6, 8. That puts us to 3. So if this thing has 3 power or more, or if there's a combat trick or a burn spell that can deliver that much power, then we lose. Tap this thing down. I don't actually want to offer a trade here. And we'll see if this Sandstorm Charger can hold down the fort. Opponent still has a lot of cards and a lot of mana, so this could definitely go upside down for us. But I think this gives us the best chance to win. Plays around a few things. Also, just our opponent having a card like a Dragon Fodder and a Morph or something that gives the Kolaghan Forerunners makes it 5, 9, 10, 11, you know, something like that. And Mob Rule. Sure, why not? All right, so we win, and this was a Stormcrag Elemental. Or so they win, I mean, and this is a Stormcrag Elemental. Yeah, that sucks. Sometimes they have it. So what do we want to do here against the big deck? I think I want a Dromaka Dunecaster again. Maybe cut a Lore Master, a little too grindy. All right. I'd like to play first. Faithful Scholar, Dragonfire, Keep. Yeah. I don't love giving that thing up if it gets twin bolted, but we're miles away from flipping it anyway, so I'd rather just develop the board out a little here. Okay, Sight Beyond Sight or Youthful Scholar? Probably just going to play the Scholar here, I think. I mean, it's tempting, but we can't even hit a land drop there, so yeah, I'm just going to play the Scholar and ship the turn. I'm not going to Vial of Dragonfire away the Sandstep Outcast. And I'm not going to trade it for my dragon either. I would trade it for the youthful scholar, but I think that, you know, if the dragon does survive, it's a really nice late game threat. I mean, this thing is, I think this is the best of those dragons. I like the black one and the white one in it. I really think this one's good. If you've ever had to play against a 4-4 lifelink flyer, even if you have to put a lot of work into it, the card can make up a lot of ground that you lost. They're very strong. Sprinting Warbrute with dash. Pretty tempted to just take this. Could be convinced to block or even double block. I do think this thing is a good enough late game play that we want to keep it. Yeah, I'm just going to take it. This can trade for an actual creature and not just the Warbrute, plus this plus a vial can trade for the Warbrute, and I get a bunch of value out of it. And my opponent doesn't get to keep it. I mean, I'm going to be on a pretty good board state here after I get to untap. Can also just leave up Whisk Away to take care of the Warbrute at some point. Okay, taking my hits. I mean, I don't like taking big hits of damage, but feel like this game, if we're going to win it, is going to go a little longer than that. So let's see what happens. All right, so we're getting there. We're getting there. This needs 7 mana. We have 5, so we need 2 more plus that. Yeah, we're getting there. Really want to play Sight Beyond Sight, but I think it might be better to leave up Whisk Away and the Vial here. So I'm just going to ship the turn back. I'll probably use the vial in any case here and take out the spirit. So kill the spirit token here and take no more damage. And this basically prevented my opponent from wanting to play the brute. Might just play it hard cast this time, but if we would have tapped out, I'm pretty sure we would have seen it. Okay. And we keep hitting our land drop, so that makes the Sight Beyond Sight a little easier for us here. So let's go with Sight Beyond Sight here, and then I think I'm just going to play Sidisi's Faithful and get rid of this Warbrute here. Set my opponent back. All right, so we want this one in hand and that one on the bottom. And then, yeah, I'm just going to play the Faithful, sack the Faithful to itself. And then bounce the Sprinting Warbrute to hand. And just pass the turn back. Then I'm going to play the land, and I'm going to flip up the Morph and hit him for 4 and try to get that whole thing going. And I think that's the line that we want to take here. My opponent dashes Sprinting Warbrute here and only attacks with it. I may just block finally with the Youthful Scholar. Getting a little bit more action here would be pretty good for us, I think. Remember, we do have this coming back too, though. Don't want to forget we got value on the virtual stack here. Morph, yes. And Forerunners. Okay. That does seem pretty good. Okay, so let's replay this and see what we get. Profaner. Profaner's good. Profaner is very nice here, in fact. We can Profaner and Whisk Away, which is kind of interesting. Now, it's only creatures with less toughness, right? Toughness less than that. So we don't have a great Profaner here. We're certainly not going to be sacking this dragon anytime soon. But if we play and sack the Profaner itself, it does take care of this and this, though it would let him recast the sand step, which is a little annoying. And it doesn't actually get the Forerunners. So it's pretty bad, to be honest. Like, that's not really a great play. So I think what I'm going to do here is pass. And this leaves us Whisk Away or the ability to turn up our dragon and block if our opponent gets hyper-aggressive. Maybe they get greedy and go for a big mob rule here or something. Oh, sending the whole team in. So the default play, I think, is to block Youthful Scholar on this and the dragon on this and kind of force my opponent to do something. If they don't, well, I think I can still just sort of flip up the dragon, and if they have a removal spell, I can live with that. But they're likely to put a bunch of mana into this morph to, you know, try to have it survive combat here, because this is not a good trade for our opponent. Yeah, they're just going to pass. All right, well, I'll bite. And if this thing dies, that's fine. I still trade for a removal spell, and I get Youthful Scholar to trade for the morph. And if my opponent decides to now put mana into the morph, then I get two cards off the Youthful Scholar, and I get to eat the Sandstep Outcast, so there's a whole lot of good stuff. Yeah, so now I get to trade for morph, and this all works out just fine. Okay, obviously bummed to not have the dragon, but so it goes. Spell Eater does some amount of work here. So I'm just going to play that thing face down and pass. This way I have Whisk Away and Will of the Naga available, or I can just Spell Eat. I kind of like both of these options. I don't even mind taking a little damage here. This is a Tormenting Voice. Okay. Can't counter it anyway. All right, I'm countering whatever this is. That's nice. Counter Sprinting Warbrute, and now no attacks from our opponent. So that's pretty good. And now we draw Ojutai Summons as well, which is very nice here too. So this is good. This is all working out. Two, three, four, five, one, two. And then I can do Will of the Naga and Whisk Away. No, I can't do both anyway. But I can leave up one of those. So let's play Ojutai Summons and leave up Whisk Away. And I still don't think I actually want to. Maybe I just play Profaner face up here. Attack here beforehand. Yeah, I think I'm actually just going to play Profaner. As a good old hill giant. Because that sets up Will of the Naga Whisk Away the best. I don't want to sack my Silumgar Spell Eater just to get marginal bounce value here. We're still at 11, and these two cards should do pretty well. Oh, never mind. We're just dead. Yeah, stupid Mob Rule. Card is so annoying, especially when it just beats you both games. All right, well, looks like that's going to do it for this one. If you guys want to find me on Twitter, I'm Marshall_LR. And, of course, you can find the podcast right here on channelfireball.com to help sharpen up your game when it comes to Limited. We'll talk to you next time.